You're in a noisy bar or chatting at a wedding reception. The background noise is unbearable and it's impossible to hear yourself speak. So what do you do? Raise your volume and move your mouth muscles more intentionally, not only to help your conversation partner to hear you, but also to hear yourself. Now, you have no apparent control over this effect when, in high noise environments, your cortex fires this response, which makes you speak louder and with more vocal effort. But we all know the outcome of speaking with noise pollution. You leave the club and wow, your voice, right? It may feel rough, sore, or sound incredibly hoarse. It's disappointing and it hardly needs to be said that you've abused your voice. Avoid noise pollution if you can. Limit or avoid spending time in noisy environments. And if you need to project your voice extensively due to background noise, you're going to get voice fatigue. There's no way around it. New research confirms that noise pollution will cause you to misuse your voice. So today, I want to provide you with a few strategies to monitor your vocal health when exposed to noise pollution. Number one, dial down the volume. Reduce the audio input level. If you plug your ears, you can reduce the input volume and increase your ability to hear yourself. I use earplugs or knobs, which help me turn down the noise level by up to 21 decibels. Number two, watch out for where you take your phone calls. Street noise, noisy office environments will all skew your voice use and increase your voice fatigue or possible misuse. Number three, warm up your voice before heading out. This ensures the voice system is better connected and gets the muscle in the best possible condition before overuse. However, remember, a vocal warm-up will not stop you from misusing your voice, so still take care. Number four, perfect your posture and ensure that there is symmetry when you speak in noisy environments. A tilt in your neck or poor posture will affect your ability to access the best breath support for voice production and could increase the risk of vocal damage. Number five, stay hydrated. If you're drinking and screaming, you'll not stack up well at the next day. Alcohol will always dehydrate the muscle, so make sure you take in enough water if you're drinking. Number six, increase your vocal IQ by learning more about vocal hygiene. Pick up our bonus vocal hygiene cheat sheet over on our website, linked below for you, and consider working on your voice tone. Creating a good sound with your voice is a skill that many people need training in. Number seven, learn acoustic voice projection strategies from a voice therapist so that you know how to create the best vocally energized sound with less wear and tear risk on the muscle. And our last one, number eight, advocate for a safe work environment if you're exposed to noise pollution. If you work in a job that places you in front of high noise pollution, advocate for amplification devices, acoustic architecture strategies to reduce the levels, because noise pollution changes your voice behavior in the worst possible ways. Over time, this can increase your risk of a voice disorder as well as well-being impacts. Are you spending time speaking in noisy environments? Let me know in the comments below how this is affecting your voice and feel free to ask me any questions you have about your voice care. I hope you enjoyed this one. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up or subscribe to the channel if you want more tips around your vocal health and overall communication. Have a great day. Ciao. Enchantée.